Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you very much, Professor Saira Afzal. आपने invite किया and Professor Bilqis Shabbir, Khalid Cheema, faculty member और ख्वातीन हज़रात. In fact, I was given the task to discuss the professionalism and role of professionalism in medical editing and medical education. King Edward Medical University is one of the prestigious institute of South Asia. We have completed 106 years of excellence in the medical education, and by the grace of Allah Almighty, our PhD program in all the basic sciences that is approved by PMC and Higher Education Commission of Pakistan. Similarly, we have got PhD in the clinical science. And I am very grateful to the faculty, especially Professor Bilqis Shabbir and the Saira Afzal, for introduction of new certification course. The first course which was introduced is the certificate in medical education. And I think the third batch has completed its certification. And then Professor Saira Afzal has started this certificate in medical editing, which is very important. And similarly, we are also going to have the post-graduation, expansion of post-graduation in public health. Already we are having the FCPS program, the MD program, the PhD program, and for the general public, for the general physician, we are going to expand this facility in the form of a diploma program. So in this way, King Edward Medical University is concentrating upon the academic, the research, the infrastructure development, and the international liaison with the help of this faculty. And remember, the difference between the college and the university is, college is for dissemination of knowledge. University is for innovation, for new thing, for research, and by the grace of Allah Almighty, this able faculty, we are trying to achieve the outcome, the targets, and one of the target is during crisis and during this COVID situation, King Edward Medical University attached hospital, they delivered in the first wave, second wave, third wave, and now in the fourth wave. We did not refuse a single patient from your hospital. We expanded these facilities to Government Nawaz Sharif Hospital and to the Yaki Gate. And similarly, on the instruction of Governor of Punjab, King Edward Medical University established the Department of the Telemedicine, where so far around 14,000 patients have been given the teleconsultation. We established tele-outdoor, tele-secretary desk, tele-nutritional desk, and tele-corona help desk under the supervision of Professor Bilqis Shabbir, Saira Afzal, and other faculty member. And just yesterday, I was witnessing the call being received from the South Africa, call being received from the China. So we have received call from the 45 different countries, from all districts of Pakistan, from South Punjab, from Karachi, from Northern area, from Gilgit-Baltistan. I think this is one humble contribution of King Edward Medical University. And we are going to establish this King telemedicine department on permanent basis. And similarly, our objective is to establish the advanced skill lab, and inshallah we will go towards the robotic surgery. Now I will go on to my topic, the professionalism. This is the model of our country, the patient care that revolves around research, knowledge, critical thinking, communication skill, teamwork, pedagogy, advocacy. And one of the most important competency is the professionalism, the ethical practices. When you start the research, what are the steps to start the research? And how important is the approval from the ethical board? And similarly, we have got the institutional review board. How important is to get the approval from the institutional review board? And finally, the other relevant forum like Advanced Research and Study Board. Coming to the challenges, one of the challenge which the postgraduate medical student or the system face is the ethics and the professionalism. And there are other challenges also. I'm just going to count these challenges. The challenges which the institution they are facing, they relates to the induction of undergraduate and the postgraduate. Similarly, there are challenges related to the training framework. And most important challenge which we are facing is the quality. Quality in medical editing, quality in the research, quality in your paper, quality in your journal, that has to be maintained, and quality in the training framework, variation in the training. The different institutions, they are having the different training model, training quality, the quality in accreditation criteria, quality in your curriculum, models of training, quality in the supervision, and how we are monitoring these things. These things, they relate to the training framework. Then the evaluation, your examination system, we have to abreast with the international norm. We have to see the different competencies, like the cognitive domain, how you are going to assess the cognitive domains, how you are going to assess the skill domain, how you are going to assess the professionalism and ethical practices. Your training, your instructional strategies should match your evaluation techniques. If they are not matching, then probably you are not evaluating your students properly. फिर आपने देखना है कि ये जो cognitive domain है, are you covering all the topics? What is the required technique for the assessment? And currently, I think the MCQs they feel can cover the broader domains. Then MCQs, the collection of the MCQs, analysis of the MCQs. When the supervisors submit one MCQ, you see the difficulty index, the discriminatory index, the reliability index. So that is very important. You are assessing the cognitive domain through MCQs and the type of MCQs. Whether true or false, one best, extending matching, all these things the examination department have to see to evaluate the competency in a uniform way. And then your skills domain, how you are going to assess your skill. One of the techniques is the workplace based assessment. जब आप काम कर रहे हो आपकी assessment हो रही है. Second, your short and long cases. You are being assessed कि आपने ये सीखे हैं. And then the most important thing which I have written in the red color is the professionalism and ethical practices. How you are going to assess your professionalism and ethical practices during the evaluation. And then you will practice these things in your practical life. When you are going to write the paper, you see how you are going to make the translate these ethical practices into the practical form. You have heard the word of plagiarism. I think we have to come out of these things, or this way we have to inculcate the culture of ethical practices in synopsis, in dissertation, in thesis writing. The definition of professionalism, that is the habitual and judicious use of communication, knowledge, technical skill, clinical reasoning, emotion, values and reflection in daily practice for the benefit of individual and the community being served. This is the definition, and then these are the attribute of the professionalism, which include the sense of responsibility, humanity, leadership, excellence, and motivation, inspiration, respect to the culture and mutual respect. All these things, they are the component of the professionalism. And similarly, how we can inculcate the professionalism. We are supposed to know the professional attire, respect for punctuality. We have to be punctual, and we should respect the punctuality and inculcate the culture of punctuality in our department. Knowledge and sensitivity towards social norm, values and belief, consciousness and reliability, integrity in the reporting facts. And then you know whether you are having a qualitative study or the quantitative study. Qualitative study, I'm sure you know the details of that thing. The qualitative study is relatively difficult. But how you are going to conduct the qualitative study? The interviewing is one of the example of the qualitative study. When you conduct the interview on any research, then you take out the themes from that interview. You do the thematic analysis, and then on that thematic analysis, you develop a questionnaire, and then you ask the question from the students. Relationship with the colleagues. Ek team ka member banna aur ek team leader hona, these are two different things. Aapne team ke member ke taur pe kaise play karna hai? आपने टीम लीडर के तौर पे कैसे करना है। आप क्रिकेट में देख लें, अगर 11 लोग टीम के मेंबर बन के टीम बनते हैं तो लीडर कैन प्ले इट्स रोल। एंड सिमिलरली द क्वालिटी ऑफ द लीडरशिप, दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि वो लीडर उन 11 को टीम का मेंबर कैसे बनाता है। इंपॉर्टेंट चीज अगेन, जब प्रोफेशनलिज्म का तस्करा करना है तो फीडबैक का तस्करा कर। फीडबैक में पंक्चुअलिटी आएगी, रिलेशनशिप आएगा, रिसर्च आएगा, इंटेग्रिटी आएगी, ऑनेस्टी आएगी, रिलेशनशिप विद द कुलीग्स, विद द जूनियर, विद द सीनियर, एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ फीडबैक यू विल गिव फाइनल असेसमेंट ऑफ द ट्रेनी इंटेग्रिटी। दिस इज समथिंग अबाउट द कॉम्पिटेंसी के ग्रीन में कितनी है, ब्लू में कितनी है, रेड में कितनी है। 80% शुड बी इन द ग्रीन, एंड दिस इज द फीडबैक विच आई वॉन्टेड टू मैंशन टू यू कि फीडबैक में कि हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू असेस द प्रोफेशनलिज्म इन द फीडबैक के सुपरवाइजर सी द पंक्चुअलिटी बिहेवियर विद द पेशेंट, विद द कुलीग्स एंड द ट्रेनिंग कोर्सेज। आप पेशेंट के पास जब आ रहे हैं तो आप उसको अस्सलामु अलैकुम कह रहे हैं, एक्सपोजर के लिए आप कैसी बात कर रहे हैं। इसी तरीके से जब आप पेशेंट का एग्जामिनेशन कंप्लीट कर रहे हैं तो आपने उसको थैंक यू कहा या नहीं कहा, उसको कवर किया कि नहीं किया, आपका बॉडी लैंग्वेज आपकी क्या थी, दैट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड दैट इंक्लूड्स इन द प्रोफेशनलिज्म। मुझे बहुत अफसोस के साथ इस बात को करना पड़ता है, कॉलेज के लेवल पे, यूनिवर्सिटी के लेवल पे जब कुछ केसेस सामने आते हैं तो दिल जलता है। आप थर्ड ईयर फोर्थ ईयर के रेजिडेंट हैं, आप सिनॉप्सिस किसी से लिखवा रहे हैं, आप डेजिटेशन किसी की कॉपी कर रहे हैं और वो कॉपी डेजिटेशन आप सबमिट करा रहे हैं, आपका ज़मीर दैट इज़ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट, वो आपको बताएगा कि आपने कितनी ऑनेस्टी के साथ इस स्टडी को कंडक्ट किया है। ये चीज़ें कहीं ना कहीं रिफ्लेक्ट होती हैं, ये चीज़ें कभी ना कभी रिफ्लेक्ट होती हैं। आपकी रिसर्च नहीं होगी, आप पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन कर गए चीट करके, इस अंदाज में कर गए, लेकिन प्रैक्टिकल फील्ड में जाके कहीं ना कहीं आपको स्टॉप लग जाएगा। कम्स बैक टू यू, आपने मेहनत से काम किया हो उसका रिवार्ड ज़रूर मिलता है, लैसल इंसान इल्ला मासा। और अगर आपने मेहनत से काम नहीं किया, किसी की मेहनत को चुराया है तो नहीं रिवार्ड मिलेगा, किसी जगह पे बात सामने आ जाएगी। वो फिर आप बेस्ट ग्रेजुएट होके भी पता नहीं क्या कर रहे होंगे उसमें। सो एथिकल प्रैक्टिसेस, रिवार्ड, दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इन चीज़ों का आप ख्याल रखिएगा। रिसर्च में दो नंबरी नहीं है, और इस्लाम यही तो सिखाता है कि नो दो नंबरी। नबी सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम मुजस्मा अखलाक, ये अखलाक और एथिकल प्रैक्टिसेस और प्रोफेशनलिज्म ये तो इस्लाम का खासा था, इसको हमने छोड़ दिया। वी हैव टू अडॉप्ट ऑल दीज क्वालिटीज, द टीचिंग ऑफ द इस्लाम। और एक बात फिर मैं कंक्लूड करते वक्त ये कहता हूँ कि आपका ज़मीर आपको बताएगा कि आप ठीक काम कर रहे हैं कि नहीं कर रहे हैं। सो थैंक यू वेरी मच लेडीज एंड